Hey guys, welcome to a game called Absolute Drift. I played it for about maybe 15-20 minutes, and it seems like a really cool game. I love the art style, it reminds me a lot of Mirror's Edge. I guess let's just go ahead and hop into it. Menu's pretty standard. One thing I did notice about this game is that it drives... If you've ever played Forza 4, you know how... Like, if you make a four-wheel drive car and then you try to drift it, it feels like it's on ice for the most part sometimes. Well, that's kind of how this game plays. It's like a four-wheel drive and then into a two-wheel drive. It's strange. But, yeah. Right, so here we go. Hello, my child. You are here to become a drifting master. Drifting is the art of sliding sideways. Let me give you some background to drifting. Drifting was created in Japan by a race car driver who had too much sake during lunchtime. I don't know how true that is, but okay. So he couldn't drive in a straight line, becoming a drifting master. Becoming a drifting master will require patience and determination. The next time we see each other, you will be a drifting master. Now go forth and hit walls. Drift. Okay, so the Funky Buddha just popped up, said what we had to do. Now, this game does support both controller and keyboard, which is nice. I'm using an Xbox 360 controller, and I love the sounds. The music, it's got like 2 hours of music. By the way, this game is on Steam, and I think it's like $12, something like that. It's not a real expensive game. It is an indie game. It's a lot of fun, but I'll take you through the tutorial. It's a lot harder than it looks, honestly, because you're going to look at me and probably be like, you dumbass, you should probably drift here or do this. But it's a lot harder than it actually looks. And it takes a little bit to get used to. Also, one thing I found is turn the steering assist off. Especially if you have any kind of background in racing games at all. You'll know steering assist is kind of a pain in the ass to deal with. But it's really easy. It's all in the settings. Oh shit! I suck at this, by the way. I'm just saying, just kind of throwing that out there. But all the cars in the game, there is multiple cars. I think right now I have like looks like a Hachiroku or an AE86, however you want to call it. And all the cars have their own unique sounds. They all have turbo sounds. I did play and unlock the second car, but I erased my data so I could start over again. And I'll take that, but okay. Oh shit, don't hit the wall. So, yeah, it's just, you know, this game is a lot of fun. For just being a little indie game, I'm honestly not sure who the developer is. But credit goes out to them because they did a fantastic job on this game. Okay, we'll go ahead and play this. Oh, this is new. I didn't do this the last time. Okay, what do I have to do? Okay, I guess I just gotta get a good score. Now, you see the post? Those are clipping points. Obviously, you want to try to get as close, do exactly the opposite of what I'm doing because I am sucking so hardcore right now. Alright, I'll take that. I'll get that one. Oh, no. But if you are playing with a controller, again, I would suggest turning the steering assist off and turning the steering sensitivity to 100%. It will make life so much easier trying to slide the car around until you get used to it. But so this is the first world. It's basically you just have these missions that you have to do, you know, drift between certain objects. You have to collect those little spinny spinny X things, these here, you know. It is a lot of fun. Oh shit, when you actually figure out how to drive in this game, it is a lot of fun to play with. You can also change the color of your car if you're not happy with it. There's a couple ways to do it. One is in the main menu, and And the other is to just drive it through this little paint booth right here. Oh, shit. Yeah. Also, I'm not sure if I said this earlier in the video, but there's like... they say there's 3 hours of music in this game, and I can pretty much believe it. I've been playing this game about 20 minutes, maybe a half hour. I've not heard the same song yet, so far it's off to a great start. Also, one other cool thing that I really like about this game is when you go through the air, it changes the music while you're in the air, which is awesome. Here, just take a listen. Yeah, that's pretty damn cool. I love that. This whole game, it for some reason, it reminds me of like a car version of Mirror's Edge. And I love Mirror's Edge, the hardcore parkour game, if you've never played it. It's an older game by EA. If you want to check it out, feel free. It's awesome. I would imagine you could probably pick it up pretty cheap nowadays since the game, I think, came out back in 2008. But, yeah. Off to Driftcana. I mean, I don't want to do too much because I want you guys to experience this for yourselves and see how it actually plays out and everything. It is a lot of fun again, and I'm sorry I keep saying that. It's just I can't put this game down. I just keep playing it. And there are some things that require a lot of practice. Like for me, this requires a lot of practice, just general driving in this game. Okay, cool, give it to me. Ah, yes, spinning inside the box. I get to be a true Ken Block. Woohoo! Now, in the settings, you do have the availability to put it on manual transmission. The only thing I don't like about that, normally when I play a racing game, I run it in manual transmission, always. No assist on manual transmission, usually with clutch if I can. But the downside to this game is that there's no key bindings, meaning you can't change the controls, which kind of sucks, because otherwise I would try to set it up like Forza Motorsport. But unfortunately I can't, so I just kind of have to deal. So I stuck it with automatic transmission. But again, I would highly suggest or highly recommend turning off all steering assist and turning your steering sensitivity to 100 if you are playing with a controller. I did play for a bit with the keyboard. You can play with the keyboard. It's a little bit more difficult, but it does kind of transition just the same as far as if you were to play with just a regular controller. I just prefer the controller. So, yeah. I'm going to skip that one because I don't want to go through that. So then you go into the second world and you unlock your first car. And if I remember where it's at, because I don't remember where it's at. I want to say the second car is like a Silvia, an S15, if I can remember where it's at. Don't know if I can remember where it's at. Ah, there we go. It's called the Super. And I want to say it's based off of the S15. Chassis. So all these cars, they pretty much, you know, they have their own sounds. They all, as far as I know, all cars have turbo sounds in this game. That's just the coolest. Can I land it? Can I land it? Nope. Oh, nice. It even says hashtag JDM on the bottom. That's funny. Yeah, it's this game is great if you are into drifting or just want a general, you know, just mess around game. It is on Steam. I'll leave a link in the description. I guess that's pretty much it. You guys have a great day, and if you enjoyed it, leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you later.